Hello everyone, this is Pragati Yadav from Sri Vaishnav Institute of Forensic Science, and today I am going to explain you about Raman spectroscopy in question document. Raman spectroscopy was first given by Sir C.V. Raman in 1928 and he got Nobel Prize for this in 1930s. We read Raman spectroscopy in terms of forensic science. Suppose an investigative officer reach at a crime scene and they found a unknown sample there over. So the analysis of that sample should be done to know the constituent of that unknown sample. Chemists use many techniques such as high performance liquid chromatography, gas chromatography, mass spectrometry, atomic absorption spectroscopy, thin layer chromatography. But these sequences of methods are all destructive techniques of analysis. So we prefer Raman spectroscopy over all these methods because Raman spectroscopy is a non. Now let's move on to our next slide, that is the principle of Raman spectroscopy. The principle of Raman spectroscopy or Raman effect, that is frequency of a small fraction scattered radiation, is different from the frequency of monochromatic radiations. In Raman spectroscopy, the beam of monochromatic light incident on a sample. The monochromatic light means the light of single color or of a single frequency or wavelength. The light of monochromatic light incident on an sample. When light incident on a sample, then light either absorb or pass through the sample. The light is scattered in two ways, elastic and inelastic way. Elastic collision is not used in Raman spectroscopy for the analysis of question document. Inelastic collision is the basic principle behind the analysis of question document. In inelastic collision, when the incident photons encounter the sample mount, then the scattered electron on the sample either loss or gain energy, and this is the basic principle behind the use of Raman spectroscopy in question document. And this shift of frequency to the energy difference between the scattered photons is called Raman shift, and this occur as stroke and anti-stroke. In stroke Raman scattering, the emitted photons have lost energy, as we can see here, from 0 to 1 energy level. And in anti-stroke Raman scattering, the emitted photons have gained energy, like here, it excited to virtual energy state to here and come with more energy and come to zero level. And here in stroke Raman scattering, they excited from zero to virtual energy state and come with loss of energy and come here. Now let's take a small view at Raman instrument. This is a Raman instrument. This is a laser light. This laser play a role of light source, which is used to produce the incident light. This light source should be monochromatic. Monochromatic means of single color and of single frequency and single wavelength. And this is a filter probe. This is the second principal component, that is lens. We can use prism also and mirror also in place of this. And this lens play a role to direct the light toward the sample. This is the sample. And the third principal component of Raman spectrometer is this spectrograph. This spectrograph detect the anti-stroke and stroke and give the information to computer. And then computer plot different graphs for different. Now let's move on to our next slide, that is applications of Raman spectroscopy. रमन स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी इज यूज टू प्रोवाइड फिंगरप्रिंट, स्ट्रक्चरल फिंगरप्रिंट बाय मीन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स विच कैन बी आइडेंटिफाइड. एंड सेकेंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ रमन स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी इज एक्सप्लोसिव एंड गनशॉट रेसिड्यूज. इन एक्सप्लोसिव एंड गनशॉट रेसिड्यूज रमन स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी इज वेरी हेल्पफुल. इन केस ऑफ एक्सप्लोसिव एंड गनशॉट रेसिड्यूज द चांसेस ऑफ द मटेरियल फाउंड एट द सीन एट द क्राइम सीन मे बी ऑफ लार्ज इन लार्ज अमाउंट और इन स्मॉल अमाउंट. बट द स्पेशलिटी ऑफ रमन स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी इज दैट इट कैन एनालाइज अ वेरी माइन्यूट क्वान्टिटी थ्रू इज एनालिट्स प्रोसेस. एंड नेक्स्ट इज इलिसिट ड्रग. इलिसिट ड्रग इट कैन ऑल्सो एनालाइज द इलिसिट ड्रग्स द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ इलिसिट ड्रग्स. एंड नेक्स्ट इज एनालिसिस इन क्वेश्चन डॉक्यूमेंट विच इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड द मेन एप्लीकेशन विच वी आर गोइंग टू रीड. क्वेश्चन डॉक्यूमेंट इज एनीथिंग हुज ऑथेंटिसिटी इज इन डाउट. And documents may contain added terms and conditions after the date of signing, overlapping text, and multiple signatures. All these can be analyzed through Raman spectroscopy. Rapid Raman imaging is the best available methods to investigate questionable document and identifying fraud. It is highly sensitive to small chemical differences. It also can determine the ink deposition on a paper. This graph is formed from Raman instrument. Here two graphs are formed simultaneously. The upper graph is of black pen and the lower is of blue pen. They give false conclusion. We may conclude that both are same and but these are black and blue pen, so we can this graph show false perception means false conclusion about the black and blue pen. Means the constituent of blue pen and black pen are both different. This can also be analyzed through visual examination. There is no need of using Raman spectrometer or Raman instrument in this. So let's move on to our next slide. That is, in this two ballpoint pen, that is point ballpoint first and ballpoint second. The graph, as we know, that ballpoint constituent are very minute chemical differences are found between the two companies of ballpen makers. As we can see, the graph here is same for both of the pen, and here also it is same. But see the minute differences of chemical atoms. This is the as Raman spectroscopy technique is very sensitive to minute chemical differences. And here we can see this the minute chemical differences between both of the graphs. And here we can easily visualize that both ballpoint pens are different. Same we can see in second graph also. So we can do these examination and easily conclude the results. Next is chronological sequencing. Chronological sequencing means the time. Chronological sequencing explain the time difference between the use of two inks. Means any agreement has been done before 5 years, and now the alteration in that agreement or manipulations are made in that agreement after 5 year or after 2 year, then we can then through chronological sequencing we can examine the differences between the time period. So through all these we can conclude that Raman spectroscopy is a good method for the analysis of question document and a accurate method. Thank you.